You're listening to the JaM-Cast with JJ and Mikey Mike. Our email is jamcast3@gmail.com.
Ladies and gentlemen,
welcome to the show.
Welcome back, my friends, to the show that never ends. We're so glad you could attend. Come inside, come inside.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have now come to the main event of the evening.
Okay, y'all, this is it.
It had to happen sooner or later.
It's party time.
We deserve an adventure.
Y'all ready for this?
Hit me.
That's a new little intro we got there. That's kind of fun.
I like that.
JaM-Cast. Welcome to JaM-Cast episode 10. We are slightly getting better at this.
Slightly. Very slightly.
We're going to do our 10-minute segment with the Maniac. Might go a little over 10 minutes because today we don't have a guest in the studio. So it's just us. It's just us having a good time. We're drinking. We're partying. Had a great supper.
Supper.
That's how they say it up in,
we had a supper.
Up in Maine. He would totally get that. It's a supper.
We had a great
What's for supper, Mammy?
Well, let's call him.
Let's call him. All right. Oh, no. Let's call him.
The damn Yankee. Right. We get the damn
Yankee. Hold on. He ain't picked up yet. Hold on. And.
Hello?
Hello, Brian. Is that you?
Yeah, I'm just finishing my supper up here in Maine.
Your supper.
How are you folks doing down there?
Do they say folks up in Maine? They don't say folks up in Maine.
They say folks. Oh, yeah.
Oh, folks? Oh, okay. I know when you drop a fork or a spoon on the floor, here comes company, right?
Oh, yeah.
Do they do that down here?
No.
The best one is somebody stop and ask for directions somewhere, right?
Yeah.
Normally, that down...
Well, you're down by Elsie's house, and you know Elsie, right? Well, she makes the best damn muffins, you know, and her daughter just graduated from high school, and they just go on and on like that.
Oh, yeah, because everybody knows everybody up there.
Yeah. What's going on down in Tennessee?
Man, we had supper. No, real talk, we had supper at a little restaurant down the street. It's actually sitting in the marina. So we went down there. I saw a billboard on the interstate as I was driving here, and I decided to stop it. It was called the Blue Moon Restaurant and Grill or something like that. And we are going to do a whole episode and review the Blue Moon Restaurant and Grill probably in the next couple of weeks. We're going to do a drone flyover, flyby. But we ate a couple of chicken wings for appetizers, and we had...
More than a couple.
You ever ate fish tacos, Brian?
No, never had those. Had some tater tacos.
What the hell? What's a tater
tacos?
Oh, tater tacos.
Yeah.
So we had fish tacos. They were pretty good. It was good.
Real good.
Yeah. What was her name?
Good one. So this is my cousin Brian Pooler up
Ma. Okay, go ahead.
Up in Windham, Maine, but we say Portland because that's the nearest big city.
Yeah.
The same way we
want people to know where I actually live.
Yeah. We don't want them to, you know, come in there and assassinate you or anything. You know, ninja sneaking in the middle of the night. So I saw this. Have you seen the post I did on Facebook? Speaking of ninjas, there was a homeless man standing on the side of the road.
I did see that.
He
yes.
said. My wife and dog were kidnapped by ninjas. I need money for kung fu lessons. I really want that dog back.
Yeah. I got to be careful on Facebook, I'll tell you. All that flirting I do, I damn near talk myself into a relationship.
Ooh.
Oh, yeah. I got to be real careful.
Me too. Me too, man.
You know what I put on there, though? What? I put when I die, I want everybody at the funeral to have a taser, and the last one standing gets my money.
Oh, that's good. I like that one.
That's real good.
There you go. I like to be there to see how that one turns out, you know?
Yeah. It'd be a fly on the wall. We could fake your death.
Wow, you know what? You know what's funny about that?
What's funny about that?
Because I got an identical twin brother.
He does. Oh, I forgot to tell you, Jay. He's got an identical twin.
Oh, really?
Yep.
Oh, yeah. And I always tell, you know, when I die, I said, just leave me at the, you know, at the morgue. And I said, you get in the casket. And when people come up and say, oh, my God, he looks so cute, just give him a wink. You know?
Oh, my God. That's classic.
And then at the church, when they're done with the service, I want them to play Pop Goes the Weasel. That would be a good one. Have a closed casket and have them play Pop Goes the Weasel. Yeah, just like, to watch everyone in the church looking at it like, oh, my God, you know what's going to happen?
Like Jack in the Box. Yeah.
That would be cool.
I love it.
And then on a tombstone, it's just going to say, here lies Brian. I told you I was sick. You know?
Yeah.
The other one I thought of is, here lies Brian, what are you looking at, you know?
He was sicker than we thought.
The other one I do is I said this to my daughter. I says, I told my brother first, I says, drop a cell phone in the casket and then give the number to my daughter and have it go like to a voicemail, which it would. Saying like, hey, I'm really alive in here. Help, I need to get out, you know? just to freak them out. I mean, that's crazy.
Man, you've really thought about this, haven't
you?
Yeah.
So, Brian, we got green screens behind us for today. So what that means is I need you to shout out right now some crazy, like, backdrop scenery, like, I don't know, African safari or the jungle or Niagara Falls waterfall.
Whatever you want.
Whatever your imagination can come up with, I'm going to put it in the background behind me or JJ right now.
How many do you want?
Shout out a couple. Like, do increment them out with about 5 seconds in between each one. So there's some time.
Why in potatoes?
What is it?
Why in potatoes?
Why in what?
Why in potatoes.
Lion?
Listen, before you do your show, you need to clean your ears. Flying as in flying. Airplanes fly.
Oh, flying.
Flying potatoes.
Flying potatoes. Okay, so flying potatoes. No, how about some reality, some real stuff?
Okay. Flying Maine lobster. Yeah.
Flying lobster.
Have you ever seen a lobster fly? Do you realize how difficult it is? I'm going to have to put a lobster on the screen flying by right now.
All right, let's do something easy. Mount St. Helens.
Okay,
there you go.
Mount
Blowing up.
Blowing up, okay. Yeah. Here goes some Mount St. Helens. Hey, there it is. Look, JJ, look. There it is. Mount St. Helens blowing up, erupting. You see it?
Now, do you do people, too?
Sure, I'll do people. Come on.
Okay, Judge Jones, Elvis Presley.
Uh-huh. There they are.
I'm trying to do the top 10 reasons why I don't go to Tennessee. They're all dead.
Wait, Judge Jones.
All my heroes are dead.
Who's Judge Jones?
Tammy Wynette, George Jones, he was a country singer.
Oh, George Jones.
Judge Jones.
Judge, you know, Judge.
Judge Jones.
You mean George?
What did I say? Didn't I say Judge Jones?
You said Judge. I'm like, you mean, who's the famous?
And the race is on, and here comes pride up
there
the
backstreet. There you go.
Oh, sing it, JJ.
Heartaches going to the inside.
Break out the guitar. By the way. You did not check your own green screen. That needs to be slid that way, and there's a big microphone right behind you.
Is there?
Yeah. Go ahead and fix that right now while I talk to my cousin.
Hey, JJ.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
What does Sister Angela look like?
She's got blonde. Any bitches? Do what? Yeah. We'll put one up on
the... One of those up there, too. I got to see what she looks like.
All right. Picture of my sister. Oh, Lord.
Wait. She's married, isn't she? She's married.
She's married.
What type of gun does she have again?
A 22.
She just bought a 22. You better keep away.
22. Wear a vest. Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Man, I was looking at a picture of you, and you kind of look like one of the blue collar comedians. What was his name?
Foxworthy?
No.
Andrew Dice Clay.
No.
You know he's coming back, don't you?
Is he?
Yeah.
He's Larry the Cable Guy. Get it done.
No, it wasn't Larry the Cable Guy.
Wait. Say that again. Get it done.
The only one I'm not going to be able to remember, there was Ron White.
Yes. No, not
Foxworthy,
Ron. And the one that you can't remember, yes.
Larry the Cable Guy and the other guy.
And the other guy is who you look like. You actually look like that guy. So we got to put a double of him.
Well, when I know his name, I have no clue to who to look for. Okay. Well,
now it's going to bug me. What was his name?
Yeah, what was that other blue collar?
Now you ask me after you get me to do all of that shit. Hang on.
Ron White. Larry the Cable Guy, Jeff Foxworthy, and...
Hang on.
Him.
The ventriloquist, Jeff Dunham.
I love
Jeff Dunham, though. He's awesome. Him and I love the old guy he does.
Honest Deke.
Yeah, I like him too, but I like the old guy.
Oh, yeah, yeah, the old guy where his eyes are closed the entire time.
Walter.
Walter.
I love Walter. Yeah,
Walter's cool.
I love Walter. We might even have some Jeff Dunham at? Behind me right now. Some Jeff Dunham.
Hey, what the hell are you looking at?
Oh, yeah. It's classic. Yeah. I love him.
Sounds bad.
So let's talk about your little doggies. What kind of dogs you got?
They're Shih Tzus.
Oh, Shih Tzus. How many jokes can we get out of this?
My granddaughter calls them Shih Tzus.
Shih Tzus.
Yeah. Two of them. Hey, Lucy and Pepper.
Oh, Lucy and Sandpepper.
Yeah, they're great dogs.
Oh, Lucy and Pepper?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, okay.
Yeah, they're great dogs.
That's awesome, man.
Yeah.
Little Shih Tzus.
Yeah, pain in the ass, but they're good little dogs.
That's good. So what'd you do all week?
Slept.
Slept every day? Just slept?
Pretty much. I don't do much. I mean, you know, I got a bunch of health issues.
When you go out of the house, what do you do?
I get on Dunkin' Donuts, get me a coffee.
Mm.
Take my neighbor, he's 70 years old, I pick him up and take him down to get him out of the house.
Oh, well, that's nice of you.
Get his discount?
I buy him a coffee. No, I buy him a his discount is me buying the coffee.
No, but he gets a discount and you go, I'm with him.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, exactly.
And this is his money that I'm giving you right now.
Usually, if he's not with me, what I'll do is I pull up to the drive-thru and I say, see the car behind me? Yeah, they're paying for it. And I take off.
I love it.
they're paying it forward.
I need another beer.
She's getting
JJ, have you ever been to Graceland?
No, I have not. I've been by there. I've never seen it.
I've driven past it.
Isn't it right by where you guys are?
Yes.
A couple hundred miles, yeah.
Three hours away.
Right around the corner, down the block, but no, I've never been there.
Yeah, a couple hundred miles. I've always wanted to go. Next time I go down to Tunica, which is a gambling place, Next time I go down there.
It's called a casino.
Yeah. Next time I go down there to the casino, I'm going to stop at Graceland and check it out. But, I've always wanted to, man. I've always wanted to see that. You know, I've always been an Elvis fan. I thought he was cool.
Yeah.
Brian, you live pretty damn close to New York and Niagara Falls. Have you ever been to Times Square or Niagara Falls?
Actually, the only time I've ever been, the closest I've ever been to New York is just driving through it going to Florida.
Yeah, exactly. Anyway. Have you ever been to Bar Harbor?
I've been to Bar Harbor many times.
In Bar Harbor fun, man. I've
so
been
you,
there.
You've never been to Times Square?
No.
He's, you know what? He's about 4 hours away, four or five hours away.
Five hours away,
and you've never been to Times Square.
No.
Look, man, look, we're going to have to come up there and go to Times Square, and we're going to go pro all of this.
Couldn't make it.
You couldn't make it?
No, too much. It's too, no. I mean, I'm serious. The farthest I go in a vehicle is like 2 miles down the road to Dunkin' Donuts. That's it. Anything beyond that, and I'm in pain.
Oh, really?
Man, that sucks. All right, tell us a joke.
Now, unless you brought your sister Angela with you, I know.
Put her in Times Square and get you to go down there. I got you.
Hey, we could go see the Naked Cowboy. Hey, when we were up there, the Naked Cowboy was right there. I'm like, oh yeah, that's the guy.
Today's show one time, yeah.
Yeah, he's like there, like even during the winter, he's there. It's unbelievable, and he actually is not insane. He's actually a straight headed.
He just does it for the show.
And he makes a lot of money.
Just for the tourists.
Yeah.
But, I mean, it must really suck in the wintertime.
But he doesn't, man. It's unbelievable. I'm sure he only does it like an hour at a time or something.
I mean, it's because of him they come up with the saying, you know, freezing your nuts off.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So, Brian, because of you, we had a few deep-hearted conversations about the show that we actually want to try to take cussing out.
Okay.
Yeah.
Not because of you, but, you know.
We kicked that idea around. At first, we wanted to be balls to the wall and say, f*** shit, this damn motherfucker, damn. Yeah. You hear all those beeps going off right now? But, in light of us doing corporate stuff and trying to promote and do other businesses, we very well can't go in, hey, look at our show, and we come out of the gate with, fuck you!
I know.
So, we're going to try to clean up the show a little bit and make it sellable.
Well, you're really doing a good job working on that. I'm proud of you.
Yeah, you like that? Fuck you, Brian.
Exactly.
But anyway, yeah, so we're going to try to clean up the show a little bit, and we're adding the green screens for effect. We kicked the idea of around of getting rid of all video, making it easier on me, but
What do you mean? You're not videotaping? You're not doing you guys in the studio?
No, we're videotaping right now. But I'm just saying, just to make life easy on me, to just make it all audio, put a single, do a slideshow or something of us out on the town or something. But I think the video is worth it. I think it's YouTube. People are going to tune in. Just, you know, maybe like that guy said today, Dougie, he said, you know, you're just getting started. And all it takes is that one or two show episodes that just takes you take off. And then everybody wants to go back and watch all your older shows that you did.
Yeah.
So exactly. I think it'll be worth it. I think it will.
So basically, you're keeping the same format. You're just cleaning it up a little bit.
Yeah, we're cleaning up the cussing, trying to make it a little bit more professional. We are still drinking beer on camera. So.
Yeah, that's fine. I went down to the store. I was going to get some. I completely forgot about it.
Here's to good times. Tonight is something special.
Kind of special.
Hey, is that this? This is that beer, right?
What are you drinking?
No.
What beer is that?
Here's to good
time. Miller Lite? No. Here's to good time.
What is that?
Milwaukee's Best?
No.
I don't know.
Here's
to good time.
You're talking about the 1980s.
Tonight is something special. Was that Colt 45?
It does.
Colt 45 was a bull brushing into the window.
Right, Colt 45 and two zigzags.
And it
was.
Yes, sir.
What kind of beer are you drinking?
Coors Light.
Coors Light. Well, that's Budweiser. Bud makes you wiser.
But we drink Budweiser too.
We drink Bud Light. We drink Miller Light. We drink
basically whatever the neighbors will buy you.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
All the light beers out there.
Whatever we can steal.
There you go. Whatever's closest to the front door.
Yeah, exactly.
Somebody once said to me, how tall are you? I says, well, it depends on what store I'm leaving.
That's good. That's classic. Who's your favorite band? Who's your favorite artist? What kind of music you listen to?
I'm 56, you know, so I like all, I grew up listening to my dad, listening to country.
Mm-hmm. So George Jones is on
the top of the list.
I like
a lot of country, but I like the old country. You know, I don't like the new. I mean, I listen to some of the new, but I like the old stuff.
Are you Hank Williams 1 or Hank Williams 2?
I like both, but I'm more like Hank Williams 2.
Okay.
Hank Jr. Yeah.
Have you heard Hank the 3rd yet?
No.
He's got some good stuff.
I listen to like Judge Jones and
Judge Jones, there he is again. He's got a show opposite Judge Judy. Yeah, I've heard that.
Yeah, hold on. I'll tell you who I listen.
Yeah, hell yeah. Judge Jones is great. He really is.
Judge Jones.
To tell you the truth, that's one of my favorite artists. That was my mother's favorite artist.
But then again, I like a lot of like 70s music, too. 70s, early 80s.
Like disco? Right. You like disco?
Doobie Brothers, Dr. Hook, you know.
Oh, yeah.
Doobie Brothers are big down here. Yep.
Eagles, you know.
Life in the Fast Lane, yep.
Elton John, Eric Carmen, you know, shit like that.
Yeah.
I played a session with Dr. Hook's old guitarist, man.
Dr. Hook, he's cool.
Yeah.
Listen to him.
All right, what would you say would be the newest urban or pop or top 40 song, that the newest song you kind of may have tuned into that you may like? What is that? You heard the Uptown Funk? Uptown Funk's gonna get.
Yeah, I don't listen to a lot of the new stuff though. Yeah. That's the problem. When I get in my car, it's all on the old.
Wait, when you get in your what?
When I get in the car, it's all on the oldie station.
You know it's pronounced car, C A R.
Yeah, car.
It's the car.
There is an R in there.
I know.
Yeah.
Hey,
but you're not using it. You're just.
Yeah.
It's just C A C A car.
Yeah, C A R car. I parked the car in the yard.
But there is an R there. It's,
I put my blink of car. I'm all set. I'm ready to go.
It's car, and there's an R.
Oh, yeah.
When's the last time you had
like
some
lobster? Roy Clark is good, you know?
When's the last time you had some lobster?
The R549?
It's been a while. As a matter of fact, I had a chance to have a lobster roll today, and I traded it in for a haddock sandwich.
Haddock sandwich, okay.
But, yeah. We got a place right down the street that it's a seafood place.
Okay, man, explain what a haddock sandwich is. We don't know what that is down here.
Fried haddock on like a hamburg bun, but it overhangs on both sides.
What is a haddock?
A fish.
A fish? Really? I mean, we don't have haddock down here. Seriously. Oh,
what are you saying? I only said that for the halibut?
Yeah, the halibut.
The halibut?
Yeah.
So haddock is a fish. It's a fish sandwich. I knew what haddock was when he said
haddock is really good. It's I guess it'd be comparable to tuna fish, but it's not as fishy, the flavor.
So like more like a codfish then.
Now, see the they all have like that fishy taste, but haddock is just different.
Like a whitefish.
It's a good fish. It's expensive.
Oh, okay.
Okay, it'd be comparable to like lobster.
Oh, okay.
Lobster.
Oh, so it's got a kind of a clear, I don't know how to explain it, but
it's a white
kind of like shark. It doesn't really have that fishy taste. It just has a...
Yeah. Like cod and all them have that fishy taste with it.
Right.
This one doesn't.
Yeah. I had shark down here one time.
But they make, like,
great.
You know, you can have like a haddock chowder.
Haddock chowder.
Yeah, I am.
Go down and sit by the lighthouse, have some haddock chowder.
Haddock chowder is like a specialty up here, but it's wicked good, I'll tell you.
It's wicked good.
Yeah.
Wicked good. You know?
I love the accent, man. I love that.
Back to
you're like, what accent?
Down in the yard, drink a beer at the party.
Yeah. I went down, remember, Mike, when we went down to Virginia?
Yeah.
Cousin Steve, huh? All he did was, all the time there was, he was all over me with my accent.
Man, I tell you what.
When I went on a ride along with him, there was one guy in the car. He pulls a guy over. The guy's doing like, I don't know, 85 and a 30.
Well, let's back up a little bit. My ex-brother-in-law was a sheriff.
Oh, he was a sergeant in the sheriff's department. I'm sorry.
So
I'm on a ride along with
him. He's on a ride along. So continue with your story. Yeah.
Okay, so there's one guy in the car. The guy's doing, you know, he's doing like 85 and a 30. So he looks at me and says, Cousin Brian, what would they do up in Maine? I said, well, you know, he'd be arrested for that because it's way over the speed limit. He says, what do you think we should do? I said, I cut him a break. So he goes up to the guy, and I'm sitting in the cruiser, but I could hear him. He's like, how you all doing tonight, you know? And gets the guy's information. He says, well, Cousin Brian says to give you a break, so I'm going to cut you a break. So then he gets back in the car. And the first thing I said to him was, what the hell is this, you all? See, up here, we don't say y'all, because when we say y'all come back, that means you're bringing relatives. So we don't. One guy in the car, he's like, how y'all doing, you know? I'm like, what the hell's that? See, that's the stuff down south I can never understand, you know?
Yeah.
Or the other thing they do down south they don't do up here is everything is, you know, Mr. Mike, Mr. JJ, you know, Miss Angela.
Yep.
Up here, they don't do that.
No.
Right. Oh, it's, hey, Brian, you know, Bob, bro, whatever, you know?
Mr. Brian.
I can't think of the term there, like a culture shock.
Yeah, culture shock. It caught you off guard.
We do the used guy. We don't do the used guys.
Because all the time I was down, everything was Cousin Brian, you know?
You know, that's how they catch me. I'll say guys. That's how they catch me.
Used guys.
Not used guys. I don't go.
You know how they catch me when I go down and say the two utes? The two utes.
We got that on video, by the way. Mike just had his microphone attached.
Hello.
One of my favorite all-time movies, you know, My Cousin Vinny.
I'm going to put this back.
Oh, I love it, too, man.
The two utes.
What are these bushy things over here?
Yeah. And what are those things on the trees? Go ahead. You can say it. Okay.
Yeah.
You know,
I love that.
Dirty screen. Oh, I love that.
One of my favorite actors.
Yesterday.
One of my favorite actors of all time is Fred. What's in it? Fred.
Fred. Yeah. He played in
The Monsters.
This is a problem with getting old. You and I can have a conversation. We know exactly what we're talking
exactly.
about.
Exactly.
Not to say any words.
Exactly. That's exactly right.
I like these type of conversations. It's like, yeah, Fred, you know him.
Yeah, you know Fred, yeah.
He was Herman Munster.
Yeah, Herman Munster, exactly.
Is it Fred Gwynn?
Fred Gwynn. Gwynn, yeah. Exactly.
He was awesome in that movie.
He was. He was great.
Who's the guy that played Vinny there? What's his name? My ex-wife would be all over me on this one.
Vinny, you're talking about, Joe Pesci?
Joe Pesci,
and then there was Ralph Macchio. And
that was a classic. I just watched that movie yesterday, too.
Did you really?
Yeah, it was on Turner Classic.
Yeah.
It was a classic.
Oh, it is. It's a great, great show, man. I love it. Absolutely love it. Mike's back up and running. He got attacked by a microphone.
Oh, okay.
Woo!
Hold on, how do I do this?
Just stick it on there.
You guys haven't played your JJ and Mikey Mike yet.
No, we hadn't. Well, go ahead, Mike, because I can't do it, man.
some technical.
Yeah, we've had disappear on the computer and everything.
All right,
what
hold
are you
on.
Saying? You guys got thieves?
No, yeah. No.
Are the two youths trying to take stuff from you?
Here's one for you.
Coming at you live out of Nashville, Tennessee. JaM-Cast.
Well, you don't like that one?
Oh, wow. That's so cool.
That's so cool.
You got to remember, I'm talking from Maine here, so it was like a 2 second delay.
That's hilarious.
That is so cool.
That is so cool. Let's see. Here's another one.
JaM-Cast, the hottest new podcast out there.
Oh, wow. That is so cool.
All right. Hold on. Here's another one for you. Let's see. Here we go. From the weird to the insane.
From the weird to the insane. You're listening to the JaM-Cast.
Oh, wow. That is so cool.
Here's one more.
Welcome to the JaM-Cast.
Okay.
Our email is jamcast3@gmail.com.
What's that as?
I'm trying to find the one that we always use.
Welcome to the JaM-Cast.
That's not it. Coming at you live. Weird and insane. Here's our email. Thanks for listening. This is kind of the end of the show.
Hey, I got a Thanks question to ask.
Huh?
I got a question to ask you.
Yeah.
You guys ever heard Mr. Obvious show?
Yes, 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 Mr. Obvious, yes.
Oh, okay.
The old Bob and Tom show, yeah.
Yeah, so you've heard all those?
Oh, yeah, yeah, classics.
Yeah, how about Rodney Carrington?
Rodney Carrington, love him.
Okay.
What's his famous song about boobs? Show them to me.
Yeah, I got the video of that one.
Oh, do you have the video where she actually shows him?
Oh yeah, up in the top. Yeah, I got one. I got just one. I don't know if you heard. I want you to hear it though.
Okay, go ahead.
Okay.
Yeah.
He's a cartoon, Aeon's rabbit, and now you can hear his sexy side. It's Elmer Fudd Reed's porno.
Suddenly, she was groping my quatch.
Elmer, like you've never heard him before.
She undressed me and grasped my erect gland.
In a performance that'll leave you breathless.
And she rubbed me and rubbed me and rubbed me until I went.
Get the new audio tape. Elmer Fudd Reads Porno. It's not dirty.
It's erotic.
It's erotic.
You like that one?
Oh, that was class. Yeah, that came through nice and clear, actually. That was good.
This is it. I got a good setup here.
Elmer Fudd does porno. Reads porno.
I don't know if you heard that one or not.
You'll get him going until Elmer Fudd goes. classic.
I know. First time I heard that, I laughed my
A lot of kids
off.
These days. Who the hell is Elmer Fudd?
Elmer Fudd. Who's Elmer Fudd?
Yeah, who is that guy?
I'm driving in my car. You remember that?
No.
You know, you heard that, haven't you?
Elmer Fudd? Driving in my car?
Yeah.
No, I'm thinking of Adam Sandler. Piece of car.
No.
Oh.
It was,
Kill the rabbit. Kill the rabbit. Elmer Fudd never drove a car.
No, there was a f***ing comedian that did Elmer Fudd.
An effing comedian? Okay, thanks. Sorry. Now I got to go back.
And beep.
And
beep that.
Yeah, good job. Sorry.
But there was a comedian that did that.
Oh, okay.
Who was it? It was Robin Williams, man.
Robin Williams did it. Okay. Yeah. Gotcha.
Titties and beer. Titties and beer. Hell yeah.
All right. You got to cut it because I'll get caught. We're going to get copyright infringement. Stop it.
Hey.
Stop it.
I seen him live, man. He's cool.
Did you?
Uh-huh. Seen him twice, actually.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, Brian, don't play any music because we'll get copyright infringements on the YouTube channel.
How much is it going to cost you?
It'll cost me losing my YouTube channel. I already have one strike on me, so two more and I'm done.
Oh. How do you do that? See, I do all kinds of crap. I never get striked.
Well, I get a check each month from YouTube. So when when you have that, when you're a partner and you're monetized, they...
How much am I getting from this? Hey, you're going to be getting a letter soon from my lawyer.
I think he's blackmailing.
Well, by the way, yeah, I have to have like millions of views just to get like $30.
Really? How many hits did we get last week?
Our video probably hit maybe 100 views, maybe.
That's viral, my book. It's funny. I go on Facebook. If I get more than 10 likes, it's like, oh my God, it's gone viral. You know, 10 likes.
Oh, that's great.
I'm like, oh my God, it's gone viral. It's gone viral.
You gotta think, man, 100 people listening to you, that's pretty cool, actually. Yeah. I mean,
well,
yeah.
What's the most hits you've ever gotten on any video?
A million, wasn't it? A
couple million.
No, it was more than that.
And how much did I get? 100?
Yeah.
You just deflated my ego here. There's no way I'm ever going to be a superstar if this continues, you know.
Yes, you can. You can be a superstar.
You're a superstar in our world, Brian. We love you.
I know.
All right, so you got any new material? Any new jokes coming your way? Am I putting you on the spot? I don't want to put you on the spot.
Well, I mean, I got a quick one I can give you off the top of my head. I don't know if it's funny or not, but...
Let's try it.
It's, what's the definition of a Yankee? It's the same thing as a quickie, but you use your own hand.
But what?
I said, what's the definition of a Yankee? It's the same thing as a quickie, but you use your own hand.
Yeah,
that's pretty good.
yeah,
I think I had to go see a speech therapist and say, hey, I like the Tennessee language, please. They sure as hell don't understand what I'm talking about. What?
Tennessee language for 200, Alex.
Yeah, can I have Tennessee for 200, please?
Yankee. Okay.
Yeah.
I think. Ooh, what was that?
Hello. What was that?
Hello.
I think he was having a Yankee.
Hello.
Good one.
How many beers have you had?
So honestly,
about four.
The Damn Yankee,
six.
The Damn Yankee Glenn Woods interview video has 55 views. Didn't even break 100.
No, really.
Well, that's what it's showing right there.
My book, 100 is pretty good.
55 views. One comment. Oh, let me see what the comment is.
Get that guy the hell off the air.
Yeah. Hold on. Let me pause it. It's going to start playing. I got to pause it. Oh, I got a Staples commercial at the beginning of my video. Comment being...
We need snacks in here. Do you have any?
Pretzels, granola bars, energy bars.
Well, there's the commercial.
Cashews, pistachios.
And that's how I get paid, by those little commercials.
Oh, cool.
Someone typed in, I have no idea who this is, but it said, Clifford Parmeter, you made my day.
I made somebody's day?
You made my day, ... I'm a big fan of the ... Have you ever noticed that in my texts and everything?
I like the yada, yada, yada.
Yada, yada, yada. Yada. Great sign. Little tip to the sign, tip to the hat, to the Seinfeld series, yada, yada, yada. But yeah, you made my day. I'm going to thumbs up that and reply with a comment.
Cool, man.
Reply with a comment. Send cash.
Send cash.
We'll find support out us. How much I made his day, huh? Send cash.
Thanks for listening. Call on please. Post,
huh?
Send cash.
Hold on.
Cash with a dollar sign.
Otherwise, I would be a therapist.
Go fund me.
Next episode. LOL. So that is live. I'm putting that right now. Hit reply. So Clifford Parmeter. I hope I'm saying it right. Parmeter. Parmeter. P-A-R-M-E-T-E-R. One day ago, commented, Clifford Parmeter, you made my day, man. Thanks for listening, man.
Clifford Parmeter, call in. We would love to talk to you.
Oh, absolutely. Email us with your number. We'll call you and then have you call in on our
show.
Secret private that? Line.
Find out exactly what I said that made his day.
What'd you say?
Whatever made his day.
Oh,
yeah. Find out. Okay, I got you. Find out what he said. Yeah, that's it. So, yeah. So, yeah, we got 55 views and 2 thumbs up. No thumbs down this time. Thanks that your daughter didn't put her little hateful thumbs down on us.
My daughter?
No. My daughter. She likes to mess with me, and she'll put.
Oh, you got one of those too?
Yes, yes.
And she'll send us. This is your first hate mail.
She wants to be.
How old's your daughter?
She's 15.
Okay, mine's going to be 31 this month.
Oh, 31.
Damn, you're old. She still messes with me.
You're old, Brian.
She still messes with you?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah, I hear you. But there's nothing like that relationship, man. It's great, father-daughter.
Absolutely.
It is wonderful. It really is. The father-son is great, but the father-daughter is just something else.
It's special.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Hey, JJ.
Yes, sir.
There's a pack of lions behind you. Turn around and look.
There is in there.
You're not scared? Hey, one's walking your way. It's walking your way.
Yeah, I got him something to eat. Here, he's gonna eat some beer.
Oh, that's
so good. Anyway.
So yeah, we're trying to come up with ideas to use this green screen behind us. What can we do? Have fun with it. You know, right now
the Civil War.
Right now I got
Mason Dixon line.
That's a good idea.
Yeah.
Or zebras fornicating behind me.
No.
There you go.
The last time you did that, man, it was like, it just made me.
Hey, can you do one of that goat going over the fence?
The three lies. Man, I used that the other day. I swear, I used your joke the other day. Go, I promise you.
There you go.
Hey, let's do a recap.
She ain't my sister. I was only helping that goat over the fence.
I was only helping that goat over the fence. I used that on Alabama the other day, I swear.
Oh, that's great.
I love it, man. Thank you.
No problem.
So what was the premise to that? The three what?
Three biggest lies.
The three biggest lies.
He said three biggest lies.
Actually, the three biggest lies in the state of Maine.
Mainer,
the trailer's
yeah.
paid for. That ain't my sister. And I was only helping that goat over the fence.
It works so well from Tennessee to Alabama, too.
It really does.
It really does, yeah.
Tennessee, Alabama, and Maine. Yeah.
Well, you could have used the toothbrush one, too.
What's that? Oh, yeah. Yeah,
they invented
exactly.
the toothbrush because any place else it would have been called the toothbrush.
To be honest with you, I think down here that joke's worn out, isn't it? How many times have you heard that one?
What, the toothbrush? Yeah. Toothbrush, yeah.
It's really worn out, but I know you guys get a kick out of it up there.
Helping the goat over the fence, I love that.
Here you go.
Do you have goats in Maine?
Up north, up in the county.
You know, we have a farm out in Smyrna that actually have zebras.
Really? A zebra farm?
Yeah. There's zebras. We have llamas.
Let me ask you a question. Have you guys ever done any cow tipping?
We were going to do cow tipping when you were visiting in Virginia that time.
No, I haven't. No.
They didn't have any cows, right?
No, they had cows. I mean, we have plenty of cows.
We went to Cow Tip, but they were outstanding in their field.
Outstanding. I love that. I love that. I did that one once. I'm going to be outside standing, so if anyone asks what I'm doing, just tell them I'm outstanding.
Exactly. Every time we drive by a cemetery, I say, Noah, people are dying to get in there.
Yeah. Exactly.
My luck is so poor, if I bought a cemetery, people would stop dying.
Oh, wow. Yeah. That's bad luck.
No, that's the truth.
That there was one I can't remember. There's a joke we used to use all the time about that. But go ahead, Mike.
Let's set me up for wasting dead air for you to try to think about it.
Yeah, exactly.
Good job. You're awesome at doing that. Thank you. All right. What can we have up on the screen right here? What can we put up on the screen? Brian, come out with something. Some scenery.
UFOs.
Because okay, I'll put UFOs right now. UFOs going on right now. All right, else? What else can you come up with? Top of your head.
I'm thinking.
Deliverance, banjo playing, and. He said, "Ding ding."
As long as I don't put any music or audio with it, I think I can put anything visual for the most part. I know there are some legalities to it, but how about a volcano erupting right now? Oh, we already did Mount St. Helens.
Yeah, Mount St. Helens, yeah.
How about roller coaster? Yeah, we're on a roller coaster. All right, make the faces like you're on a roller coaster ride, JJ. All right, on a count of three, put your hands up. One, two, three, put your hands up. Hey! Ready? Head to the left. To the right. Head to the left.
This is silly. Anyway,
wait. It's silly now, but wait till the footage is behind us. Great. You'd be like, "Holy shit, that looks so cool." Holy bleep, that looks so bleep cool.
See, man, you done messed yourself up. And
you guys really need a beep button.
Yeah, we do.
No, that's in editing, and I'm gonna have to start editing.
You don't do editing.
Yeah, he's right. He doesn't do editing.
Okay, you need a beep button, or you need an editor.
An editor.
Yeah.
Wait a minute. Are you sure it's not an editor?
I'm gonna start mimicking you, and I'll be ayah, and
but
people down here
you're not saying it
whip
right.
My
it's
ass.
No, ayah. It's ayah.
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 Yeah.
You gotta end it with the yah.
Yeah. I met the guitarist for Poison. What was his name?
Don't do this to me.
I'm sorry.
I don't know my 80s band.
CC DeVille. I met the cat one time down here, and he's like a Mainer. And he's I can't remember exactly where he's from, but he was like, "Hey doll," talking about, my ex-wife and all of that. Yeah. "Hey doll," and had all of that, and I've called girls doll ever since then, because I thought that was so cool that he called, he called people doll, and his voice was just, it was so different,
Yeah.
And it was cool. It really was. The Mainer thing was, I don't know. Do they call everybody doll up there, or is that just
no?
No,
don't use that term. No.
Really?
I've never heard it. No.
Hey, doll.
Really?
I've heard people use it, but it's not a Maine
thing.
Hey,
doll.
What would be some of the other classic Maine, Maine sayings or phrases or you know?
Like, hey, dog. Yeah.
Uh-huh. What's up, dog?
Are you sure you weren't wasted and he was saying to your wife, "Hey, dog."
Yeah, dog. Yeah.
Give me 5 or 6 beers and I might be, "Hey, doll."
During the divorce, that's what I was saying, but
All right. So what are some of the other common things Mainers do?
Eat lobster.
Eat oyster, clam bakes.
Blueberry picking.
Clam bakes are not actually baking clams. Let's get that clarified.
Yeah, it is. Clam bake. They bake clams.
I thought they boiled clams at a clam bake.
They boil them?
They boil them.
B-O-O-W.
B-O-I-L.
Okay, sound like you're saying blow them. they boil them, but it's a bake. They set it up as a clam bake. Usually a clam bake has like lobster clams and potatoes. All that stuff. A
lot of potato farms up in Maine, huh?
Up in the county, up in northern Maine, yeah. There's a lot of
And peanuts. Peanuts are big in Maine.
Right? That's a Georgia thing.
Is that Georgia?
Yeah.
Peanuts is Georgia? I thought
that's what Billy Carter used to do.
Yeah, that's exactly right.
Peanut farmer.
What about, so you got paper mills, a lot of paper mills.
Got expensive after he was in office.
Let me tell you about the paper mills. There was like 8 or 10 of them up here, but half of them are out of business, and the other half are on their way out.
No
they're
kidding.
They're closing those down. No, they're closing them on a regular basis.
Because of the internet?
Because certain types of papers they're not using anymore, the kind of paper they make. But they're putting hundreds and hundreds of people out of work.
Oh, wow.
And some of these guys have been there 30, 35 years, and they don't know anything else but.
Wow, man.
Wow. Yeah.
Yeah.
Welcome to America.
So what other you got the tuna fishing up there off the East Coast, down lower towards Massachusetts. Give me one. And what else we got up there? We got potatoes, paper mills,
blueberries,
lobster, pine trees every freaking where.
Yeah.
Oh, moose. Let's talk
we
about
have moose.
You
we
got
have
a
deer.
You got
deer,
a
moose.
Do you
black bear.
Do you have a great moose story?
I've only seen one moose my whole life.
Really?
Yeah, they're all up north. They don't come down this way.
Okay.
They stay up in the northern half of the state. They very rarely do that. Once in a while, one will escape and come down this way.
Have you ever seen a sign on the side of the road that said moose crossing?
And I stopped and I let them cross.
Hey, can I tell you a story? When I lived in Bangor.
Banger?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Stephen King lives in Bangor, Maine.
Yeah, I didn't know you lived in Bangor.
I lived in Bangor for 6 months. Yeah, me and my ex-wife, and wanted to get closer to my real father, Alan.
Yeah.
And we stayed there, but we lived 5 minutes away from Stephen King.
Yeah.
And one day we would go over to, you know, his house and be like tourists and pull out in front of his house and stalk him for a little while. And
yeah.
But he's got a typical house for the street that he lives on. It's just a normal suburb street. And
yeah, I've seen pictures of it.
And then, but he does have a 6-car garage behind his house. And he's got his fence is a big wrought iron, you know, iron fence, but nothing spectacular about it except the front gate.
Yeah.
The front gate is a big spider web.
Okay.
So right now, if I've got any footage of Stephen King's front gate being the big spider web.
Wall.
And I think he's got gargoyles on each post. Gargoyles on each post of the wrought iron fence gate.
Yeah.
So other than that, I met him twice. I passed him in Bahaba.
Uh-huh.
He drives. He at the time he was driving a red Mercedes.
Yeah.
And we both stopped in the city of Bangor. You have to stop at the crosswalk if there's someone standing ready to cross. So I stopped because it was a little old lady. So she's hobbling across, and I, lo and behold, stopped on the other side of the road, going the other direction, was Stephen King.
Wow.
So I did the fingers off the steering wheel wave, the two fingers.
Stephen King?
Yeah. And, hey, and he gave me the salute, you know, the Benny Hill salute. and the old lady, you know, got to the other side, and then we drove on past each other.
That's cool.
I thought he was going to say that you ran your lady over trying to wave to Stephen King.
I should have said that for a better story, but.
Well, you want to hear a good story. I organized a threesome last night. There were a couple of no-shows, but I still had a good time.
You had a good time without him?
I did the same thing, brother.
Last night. Imagine that.
I love it.
There you go.
So JJ just went and got us a couple of fresh cold ones. So you drinking your coffee? Oh, he's a big coffee drinker.
He loves
coffee.
Well, I cut back some. I'm not drinking as much as I used to because it's too much acid in my stomach.
I got a cousin that drinks it all day long during the summer.
One time in my life, back in the late 80s, I was drinking probably 16 cups a day.
Holy crap.
I cut back now. I drink probably a half a cup a day.
That's a lot of coffee.
Yeah. Oh, it kept me awake.
What's your brand of choice coffee?
Dunkin' Donuts.
Dunkin' coffee? Yeah.
Yeah.
That's good, man.
I've been drinking for the last 25, 30
years. I mean, do you buy that at the store, the Dunkin' Donuts brand?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
No, I just go down to the drive-thru. I mean, if I'm home, I got Maxwell House.
That's what I was going to say. I drink Maxwell House.
Maxwell House.
The only reason I drink it is because it says it's good to the last drop, but I'm trying to figure out what's wrong with the last drop.
It's good to the last drop.
Do you know that was manufactured for years and years and years about maybe a mile and a half from this place where we're recording at this point?
Yeah. Really?
Yeah, right up here.
Hey, I got a question, Mike.
Maxwell House.
Maxwell House.
How do you?
Is that why the Maxwell House Hotel is over there?
Yes.
I did not know that.
You didn't know that?
Yeah. I had no.
Right up here on Charlotte.
Mind blown.
Right up here on Charlotte. I need.
Hold on. I need explosion visuals behind me right now. Cool guys don't look at explosions. Have you not ever heard that Saturday Night Live, Andy Samberg?
Yeah.
Cool guys don't look at explosions, and it shows every movie scene of guys walking away and the explosions behind them.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah, I've seen that.
Yeah. So, yeah, Maxwell House. I did not know that. Right up the road, huh?
Right up the road.
You know, as a truck driver, part of the coolest parts about being a truck driver is you hit a lot of big, well-known factories. And one of the – I have two stories. One, I was in New Jersey – and I hit the
Jersey,
Johnson & Johnson Band-Aid factory.
Yeah.
Okay, so I go in there, and my truck was loaded with 50-gallon drums full of a chemical that went to one part of the adhesive because I backed in, I loaded in, you know, to the dock, and I talked to the dock hand. He's like, we started talking. I'm like, man, this is really cool. This is where the Band-Aids are made. He goes, yeah. He goes,
they're,
you know,
not set up what they used to be, though.
He said, you know the chemical that you got right there? I said, yeah. He says, that's one of seven chemicals that we use to make the little sticky stuff on the back of the Band-Aid that sticks to your skin.
Cool.
That's crazy.
So it takes seven chemicals, and I had a truckload of one of them to make that adhesive, all right? So then he said, can I give you a tour? I'm like, absolutely. So we go in the factory, and, man, you know how the Band-Aids are attached to each other? You have to break them apart.
Yeah. Yeah.
They're literally like ticker tapes across, like, everywhere. Like, zinging to the left, zinging to the right, going to different areas of the place, big, thick, small, little. And I'm going, you know, it was crazy, and there's people and machinery everywhere. And all this menu, you know, robotics and things doing things. And then he showed me a bin with all the paper. He said, you see those big rolls of paper? And this one roll of paper was as big as a van. Just one roll. He goes, that's that little part that you peel off and throw away.
Wow.
You know, when you
that
peel it off.
Uh-huh.
I said, that huge, you know, 2-ton roll of paper, probably heavier than that. He goes, yeah. So then we went to the end, and we got to the very end of the production line, right? And I'm thinking, oh, this is where they box them up, and they pack them into the trucks and ship them out on the other side of the building, right?
Yeah.
There's like 50. Hello?
I'm here.
There's like 50 80-year-old women lined up. They're all in their 80s. What the? You got a call beep.
Yeah, there. Call waiting.
Don't answer it. But anyway, you got all these old ladies at the very end of the production line gathering up the Band-Aids and stuffing them into those little aluminum cans.
Really?
And I said, wait a minute. You got all this production, all this fancy zing, zing, zing.
And then a bunch of 80-year-old
women. And a bunch of little 80-year-old women hand-packing them into those aluminum cans, folding the lid off, sticking them in a box to ship them off to the stores.
Wow.
I just thought that was the coolest thing.
That is.
You know, all this automation. Okay, my other story was, in Tennessee, I stopped at the Hostess factory where they make Twinkies.
Yeah.
And you know, the snowballs and the what's the
Zingers.
The Zingers, and then what's the brown one?
Oh, I love the Zingers, man. Oh,
not Little Debbie's, but what's the brown one? The snowballs, the Twinkies.
Ho-hos.
Ho-hos, and yes. Anyway. So I went in that factory. Let me just tell you. You ever walk past a Cinnabon and the smell gets you?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Go into a Twinkie factory. That smell is unbelievable. You just want to
eat everything.
You just want to lick the walls.
Wow.
But anyway, I was watching them make Twinkies, and the machine comes up, and a 3-prong machine goes to the back of the Twinkie and injects the filling, and it just keeps on going down.
The only reason I graduated from high school was Zingers and Mountain Dew. That's it. Zingers and Mountain Dew got me through high school. That's exactly.
Wow.
Yeah, Mountain Dew is real big down here.
Yeah.
Real big.
Do you like do you guys have Mountain Dew?
Yeah. We have it up, yeah.
And, do you?
Yeah, but that's everybody drinks it down here. That's why everybody's got three teeth.
Yeah.
it'll rot your teeth out.
Yeah, well, what do you guys got up there? What's the, you know, if you go into a store,
Pepsi, Mountain Dew.
Same stuff, man. Same
well,
stuff.
Well, get a lot of those energy drinks, though.
Yeah.
Hey, growing up, remember, what was it? Was it Zorax? Remember Zorax? It was like a Kool-Aid mix, but it was a...
Oh, Zorax.
Zorax.
You know what's funny? I tried some of that, right?
Uh-huh.
Way back. And, damn, there must have been like about 2,000 gallons of sugar in that damn thing. And I'm thinking, how the hell do we, you know, drink that when we were little?
It's unbelievable, yeah.
It's just there was too much sugar.
Things of the 70s. We drove big wheels. We drank Zorax or Kool-Aid.
We used to have up here. They don't have any more. Well, they do, but they're rare as red hot dogs.
Like oh, red that's right. When we went to Maine.
I brought some down to Virginia when I went down there.
You have to get the red hot dogs. And what they are, it's a. I don't know what brand. What brand are they? What's the brand?
Originally, they were from Jordan's Meats.
Okay. But
they went out of business, but somehow somebody else bought them out.
Basically. It's a statewide known fact that you eat at the cookouts, you get the red hot dogs, and they're all connected. You ever seen the old black and white movies on Pluto?
Yeah.
The hot dogs are linked together.
Yeah.
That's what these were.
Yeah.
Okay, so they literally are red, like red snappers. Mm-hmm. The meat actually has a red tint to them. So you have to bust them apart, and you cook them. They're long, and they're super extra skinny. And, my God, they are the best hot dogs I've ever had in my life.
Yeah, they are.
Beats Nathan's, beats any hot dog that you could buy off the shelf. And the last thing is Italian sandwiches. Who's the guy to go to? What's the restaurant?
Amato's. Amato's. They're the ones that invented the Italian sandwich.
The Italian, and it's got vinegar, ham and cheese.
No, Mike. Hold on.
Here we go.
Ham and cheese, green peppers, onions, tomatoes, black olives.
Oh my
god.
And oil, salt and vinegar.
And the biggest part of the whole thing is they make their own bread.
The bread.
The bread is what's, that's the big selling point.
Man, you just talk to the inner Italian in me. I got some Italian blood in me, man, and you just talk to it right there.
And they roll it up in wax paper.
I wanted to drive north when you started talking about that. Seriously.
Roll it up in wax paper and big knife, cuts it in half and at an angle.
Oh, yeah. And, oh, they're great.
Man, look, same what he just described, I was eating those when I was 5-6 years old.
I do this thing here usually twice a year where I pay for it, but I'll go out down to Amato's, buy like 30 Italian sandwiches, and then invite everybody in the family over.
Oh, my goodness.
Nothing like it.
Sandwiches, soda, chips, and,
absolutely nothing like it. When I was there, we had to eat lobster, had to have Amato's Italian sandwiches.
Yep,
and the red, when you bite into those red hot dogs, they snap.
Yeah.
They the outer casing will snap.
I know what you're talking about. Yeah.
So, yeah,
we have to have it. Yeah.
We eat good up here. We got good food.
I am going to come up there. I got to come up there, man. That is, you're talking to me. Really, fried onions, anything. Mike's talking to me now.
Oh, my ass is talking to you.
Come on, man. Don't be waving it my way. Come on.
Woo!
I definitely want you guys to come up.
Smells like fish tacos. Next year. We'll come up next year.
Well, yeah. We'll plan on something.
Absolutely.
Right now, there's a few unknowns going on around here, so I don't know.
My Italian blood in me is really, really drawing me up there to that.
You'd have fun up here, JJ. I think you'd have fun.
You know what we need to do?
Have a blast.
Go up there.
Definitely make your trip enjoyable.
And just do all the classic nostalgic things, the clam bakes, the lobster boil, red snapper hot dogs, the Italian sandwiches, and then go pick potatoes while we're hanging out at the paper mill.
There you go. And then you've done it all.
And then you've experienced.
We'll get that damn postcard and send you home.
And get chased by a bear while we're looking for moose.
You know what's funny? Way back, I was driving a tow truck, and one of the tows they sent me on was way up to the top of the very, very top of Maine, which from Portland is probably about an 11-hour ride.
Yeah.
It was weird. I got up there, I did my, my tow, I dropped the car off, and I'm coming back down the interstate, and that's the only time in my life I've ever seen a black bear. And I'm talking, there was probably 4 or 5 of them on the side of the road. There was tons of moose. And then as you get closer and closer to Portland, then you start seeing deer and things like that. But I've never seen a black bear until I get up to the top of Maine.
Your whole life? I mean, living in the state of Maine, bear everywhere.
Like I said, they make it sound like they are, but they're really not. They stay away from the city.
Right, right.
They're all in the top half of Maine, because it's all woods.
Yeah, yeah. There's a lot of land up there not settled, so.
Oh, the state of Maine's funny because if you looked at the state and drew a line right through the middle of it going across and then headed south, that's all the busy section. The whole top half is 99% woods.
Woods, trees, like unsettled, undiscovered.
My cousin who just passed away, he went up in Maine and bought, this was a few years back, but he bought like 450 acres of land.
Nice.
Wow.
I built a couple of log cabins and stuff, one for him, one for his mother and father.
Nice.
But,
And when they say a log cabin, it's not no pre-manufactured log home. It's a log cabin.
It's a funny story because this one here was a one you had to put together.
Oh.
To be honest with you. But
never mind.
At the time, he was in Singapore, okay?
Okay.
And he bought it in this little town up in Maine called Benedicta. And everybody in town, while he was in Singapore, got together, and they built the house for him. When he come back from Singapore, his house was all built.
No way.
Isn't that cool?
That is cool.
But they're the type of people out there. If you break down, you'll have 4 or 5, strangers coming towards you saying, hey, can we help fix your car? you know?
Yeah, it's so isolated up there, yeah.
Man, that's cool.
Yeah, but, yeah, everybody knows everybody, stuff like that.
Yep, yep.
I don't know if I'd want to live up there. I don't know if I'd want to live in a town where everybody knows me, you know?
Yeah.
It, I mean, you can't really do anything.
Yeah, you can't fart. Man.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah,
people know about it.
You know? But, and Chris, if there's one pretty girl, you know every guy in town's had her.
Yep.
I mean, she's been around the block a few times.
As opposed to a big town where you think that every guy hasn't had her, but they have. You know?
I knew way back that I had a sad life when a nymphomaniac come up to me and said, "Hey, let's just be friends." You know. You know what I'm saying?
I've had that happen.
That's
the difference in a whore and a bitch. That's the difference right there.
Yeah, let's just be friends.
Thanks. Those two more bleeps I got to put in there. Thanks.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Okay. Bleep and a bleep.
All right, Brian. So let's go ahead and wrap this thing up. It was great talking to you, man.
All right, guys.
This is a whole show in itself, man. That was awesome.
Oh, give me a holler next week. I'm here.
Absolutely, we'll do it. We love you, man.
Bye. Thank you.
Hey, you guys have a good week.
All right, brother. You too. Yeah.
Take it easy.
All right, love you.
Such a cool guy, man. You gotta love him.
Whoa, what was that?
I don't know. You gotta love him though. He's cool as I like him. Cool as bleep.
I like him a lot.
I like him a lot.
That was my Brian. That was my Brian.
Drink another one.
Hold on. Let me sober up a little bit.
Cousin Brian. Your cousin Brian.
That was cousin Brian way on up there. And I was trying to think of some Portland, sort of fancy Maine. Yankee word to say way on up there in them hill, them up yonder. Hills up yonder. They don't say that.
They don't say yonder.
My first memory of meeting my stepfather, who grew up, was born and raised here in West Nashville. He met my mother in Maine. He was staying with us, and being 6 years old, he said, "Michael, go back yonder and get my lighter for my cigarettes," or something like that. And
I was like, "What the fuck is yonder?
I'm like, where's yonder?"
There's another bleep. I'm sorry.
I had no clue where yonder was. I mean, if you would have said, "Go back in the bedroom," yeah. He said, "Go back yonder." Yonder was never even in our vocabulary. We had no clue what to him. It was like everyday words, you know. But right. Yeah, it was my first Southern experience with Southern language. But anyway, Brian, we love you, man. Thank you for calling in or answering our call.
There. We're getting up there. I promise.
Oh, man, he's a great guy.
We're getting up there.
We're going to get up there. Next summer. We'll go next summer.
Absolutely.
All right. So that's going to do it for us on this episode, this show. We're going to say goodbye to everybody. That was 30, 40 minutes with the damn Yankee, wasn't it?
An hour and 13 minutes.
Are you kidding me?
A little over an hour, yeah.
Wow. Time flew.
Yeah, yeah. Give us some music, man. Let's go.
I don't have any music ready.
Let's see. I don't know.
I can always edit in music afterwards. Where's my DJ tools? Oh, to the bottom. Closers? All right, here we go. Here we go. We're exiting on this right here.
Come on, stick around. Let's have some more fun.
Hey, maybe you haven't been keeping up on current events, but we just got our asses kicked, pal.
Thank you, and good night.
Oh, darn it, Mr. Lamar. You use your tongue prettier than a $20 whore.
And in honor of Brian.
Elvis has left the building. Thank you, and good night.
Good night.
That's it.